So this is the engine. Today we're going to use this Peel 3D scanner, which is a light source scanner. So it works in that way that it gives like a pattern onto the surfaces, and there are cameras reading the distortion of that pattern. And based on the distortion, that tells the software what kind of digital surfaces it should build.
After exporting the scan model as an STL file, I open it up in SOLIDWORKS for further post-processing in order to make it ready for Arne to start designing the brackets. And to help me get the job done, I used an add-in called Geometric for SOLIDWORKS. And this is an add-in from Octon that holds a great number of tools to let you know, work with mesh geometry directly inside the CAD software. And as you can see, using the import option, this STL file opens up directly. Without any problems, so that's good. And being a SOLIDWORKS user for many years, it's great for me to be able to use this well-known software and user interface to get the job done. So the first thing I do when importing mesh files is to run a repair to clean up the model. And as you can see in this case, SOLIDWORKS Geomagic found over 7,000 intersections and almost 10,000 splice vertices. So it's good to get that cleaned up. So clicking repair and yeah, everything gets cleaned up and fixed in no time. So this mesh model consists of triangular elements, and after cleanup it's a good idea to perform a remesh of these elements. And by using the remesh option in Geomagic for SOLIDWORKS, I'm able to clean up the mesh in the model. And this gives me a better and more uniform mesh, and it also reduces the file size. So in this case, I tell the software to create element length of 0.8 millimeter for each edge. For Arne to be able to work with the scan geometry, he needs some references to attach to. And therefore, I'll create a few reference planes and an axis around the geometry so that it has some fixed points and planes to work with. As you can see, when I select a surface on the mesh geometry, it automatically gives me a proposal of a reference plane on that specific surface. And we can also do adjustment to the placement of the plane if it's not laying correctly. And in order to see this, we can use the deviation analysis tool that creates a color map to show how good that reference plane matches the surface, as you can see in here. So having the first reference plane in place, I'll create a second reference plane on the opposite side of this engine block. So using the same procedure, just selecting reference plane, click on the surface, OK, and the reference plane is in place. And we will speed things up, and I will create some reference planes also on the outside of the engine here. So as you can see, it's quite easy to get these reference planes in place when we're able to click directly on the mesh geometry. Another great tool that we have in Geomagic for SOLIDWORKS is something called cross-section. So this tool extracts the contours of a cross-section and generates a SOLIDWORKS sketch. So how this works is that we select a surface in the mesh geometry, and we specify like the direction and placement of the reference plane, and you can see the preview of the contours of the geometry there. So where this reference plane now slices through the model, it will extract the contours and create a SOLIDWORKS sketch with those sketch entities. So as you can can see now when I zoom in my history tree, I have now a mesh sketch 1, which is a newly generated sketch. If I hide the mesh geometry, we'll see the sketch more clearly. So here we can see that it has generated a sketch with the contours. Of course, it takes all the contours where this plane slices through the model. In this case, I only want this specific region, which is going to be used as a reference for creating the bracket for the oil pump later on. So what I do is just to create a line and I limit down the sketch region, and then I'll use the trim tools in SOLIDWORKS in order to delete the rest of the sketch contours that I don't need for this specific task. And as you can see, this is a construction geometry, so but I can easily convert it into solid sketch geometry by selecting the sketch entities. And as you can see, now I have a closed sketch that can be used for SOLIDWORKS features later on. So these contour sketches can be used to create SOLIDWORKS features such as revolved, loft, extrudes, and so on. And here you can now see that I created some bodies and reference geometry, and this is what Arne needs in order to be able to design his oil pump bracket.
Hello, Arne.
Hello, Stian.
All good?
Everything is good here, and you, yourself?
Yeah, great. So, sitting and working with the scan of the engine that we did.
Yeah, cool.
Weeks ago.
So we scanned our engine, and I wonder, where do we go from now? Because we need some reference, some solid parts, and some solid planes to get to continue our development of these parts.
Yeah. I mean, the scan in itself is just like point cloud, so it's not like really usable the way it is directly from the scanner. But I've taken it through the peel.os software, which I'm using with the peel scanner, and done some cleanup on it, and also some alignment due to the global coordinate system. As you can see here, I have the reference axis. So this is great to have when you import it into a CAD software later on, so that your pile of the model just swirl into space when you try to rotate it. So it's okay to have the origin in more or less in center at least. Try to adjust a little more, and then I go to improve, and there we can also go in like shot off holes and everything, but still it's just a point cloud, so we need to get it into some kind of solid geometry, or at least put some references in there. So to be able to do that, there are several ways. I could, of course, take it directly into the peel.cad, which is the reverse engineering part of this peel software. But with this project, since you are a SOLIDWORKS user, I will use an add-in in SOLIDWORKS called Geomagic for SOLIDWORKS, which is an add-in that lets you work with mesh files. It's able to reference and see like mesh geometry, so you can click on surfaces and these kind of things, which is not possible if you don't have this kind of add-ins. So I'll just save the file out at STL file, and then I can import it into SOLIDWORKS later on. For you, what do you need? To design the bracket. So I would think we need to insert some references, planes, and solid geometry, and so on. Not sure whether maybe you can try to. Okay, so now you are able to help me look at this part. So it's
I mean, it's the bracket for the oil pump, correct? So
yeah.
So in which area do you want to design the bracket? So that's the first main thing I would say.
So for the bracket, we will use this part of the engine over here, and I'm looking at utilizing this hole as well as this hole and this to make the bracket. And I think that these would definitely be enough for us, and then we can make a bracket in of sheet metal parts and probably weld some reinforcement so it doesn't crack or have some vibrations or so on, and I think we need to simulate that part in SolidWorks simulation to see how much vibration it withstands as well.
Yeah, we could definitely help out with that. So now I have an explanation and an understanding of what part of the geometry that you need for this bracket. Maybe since you already have the engine, I can put in some more references as well, so you're able to do work further down the line on this.
So what we would probably need for further developments down the road, it's the exhaust flange on the sides here, as well as the flange underneath to mount our dry sump oil pan. The flange on the back for the bell housing to mount the gearbox, as well as the flange here for the inlet manifold. And I think with that we can utilize that to make more parts down the line, and that would definitely benefit us a lot.
Okay, thank you for this information, Tor Arne. It was really great to get a better understanding of what you need and what I need to do for you to be able to further do your work. So and I know that we have tools in Geomagic for SolidWorks that definitely can do what you ask for. So I'll just go ahead and create the reference planes, axis, solid geometry, and so on that is needed for you to continue with the bracket. Sounds good?
Oh yeah, that would be amazing. That would help us out a lot. So yeah, thank you so much for that. And hopefully we talk very soon. We are eager to start working on these parts, and yeah.
I think it will be great. So
yeah,
just go ahead and start designing. So leave me alone.
Yeah. Okay, I will leave you alone, Stian.
Yeah.
Have a nice day, and get to work.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
See you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
So now that I've gotten the files from Stian, he's done a job in Geomatic for SolidWorks, I will also show a different approach that we use for 3D scan products. What we do is directly use the mesh file. I'm selecting here yellow color because it shows easier on the part itself or the mesh file itself. Because using shaded edges in a mesh file creates a lot of lines. So now I'm going to insert and surface from mesh, and there you can choose a range of faces down where you want to make a plane. Here you can then it takes these faces that you chosen or the triangles, and it makes an average of that and creates a plane. So now you can see we have created a surface from that mesh. Now we'll do this to the other surfaces that I need to make the part, and I use the same method for all these. I try to make 4 to 5 points each plane regarding how big it is and how important it is. So to make this part as good as possible, I've done some measurement on my real car, and here is a mock-up of the exhaust flange. Now we'll start the assembly, putting all the pieces together of stuff that could be in the way for our oil sump. Here you can see the oil pan we created. We knew how the flange should be from previous builds, so this is simply an upgrade from that one, and now we will put it on the engine in the assembly. So now I added the anti-cavitation baffles, which will be where we pull the scavenge out of the oil pan. This is a theory we have. We don't know if it works, but we will definitely give it a try to try and pull as much air as possible out of the oil before it goes to scavenge. So now I'm going to show you how we utilize the mesh file with the surfaces we created. Now I made a simple sheet metal part with the flange of the oil pump. From this, it's easy to do edit part and then use the mesh file as a reference and then create all the bends. This is obviously created beforehand, so I'm just taking you through the build tree. But this is pretty easy to be done. All you need to do is visualize and see where you are going with the parts, which can be quite difficult at times, but it's easy to look and go out of edit parts and see where you're at. So after a lot of work in CAD and modeling, we now have a complete dry sump system drawn up. Can't show all the secrets, but definitely ask questions if there's anything you wonder about. So here I added the hoses. Now I will also add the rest of the chassis of the car to check for clearance for the hoses and see if we have any collisions. So here you can see we have the subframe of the car as well as the main rails. And now it's easy to see if something of the oil pan or the oil pump needs to be changed to make this work. But this seems like a good fit and we're ready to go.